Hello there, welcome to Ms.RedNebula's Planko Tips, Thememaker's Toolkit Edition. We created the shape of our sign in the last video. In this part of the tutorial, we'll add the image, set up LODs, export the mesh and assemble our zip file, and get a finished sign into Planet Coaster via the Thememaker's Toolkit. Let's jump right in. To get the image to show on the sign in-game, there's a couple of things we have to do in Blender. First, let's add a material. Select the sign by right-clicking on it. Go to the Materials tab on the very right-hand side of the screen. If you can't see the icon, you may have to stretch this toolbar a little wider. Click New. If the options you get look different from mine, make sure you're on Cycles Render up here at the top of the screen, not Blender Render. You may also see a button on the Materials tab that says Use Nodes. If so, click it. The material name here is very important. Whatever the name of the material will also be the first part of the name of the image files you upload with your object, and it must match exactly, including capitalization. Double-click on the name Material and change it to Popcorn with an uppercase P. Now, anything else you do in the materials does not matter in Planet Coaster, only the name of the material is important. So no matter what kinds of shaders or effects you apply here, they will not show in-game. The look of the object in-game is accomplished entirely with the PNG image files you upload with your mesh. More on that later. What we will do here, though, is apply our popcorn bucket graphic so we can see where it will appear in the game later. In the Surface section, next to Color, click the gray button on the right side and choose Image Texture. Click Open. Locate the popcorn_bc.png image and open it. You won't see anything at first because we haven't yet told the mesh how we want to display the material on it. You do so with a UV map. Go into edit mode and then change the display method to material here. Next, drag the bottom view open wider. If you don't have a bottom view, look for these diagonal lines down in the bottom left corner, click, and drag upward to open a new view. Change this view to the UV image editor. Click here and choose the popcorn image to show it in this view. Go to the Shading UVs tab in the left tools menu. There are several ways to UV unwrap your mesh, but this is a very easy method that works well for a simple, flat object. Go into top orthographic view with the number pad keys 5 and 7. Check that it says top ortho in the top left corner of the view. Make sure your entire object is selected by pressing A. Under UV Mapping, click Unwrap and choose Project from View. Look down at the image and notice an outline of the mesh has appeared in this view and its location corresponds to what you now see on the model. You can grab and move this with the G key just like in the main view, as well as scaling it with the S key and rotating it with the R key. Go ahead and position it so that it fits around the popcorn bucket with a little bit of white space around it. Making the UV map this way is a little limiting, but if all you want to do is make a simple sign like this, it's perfect. The food signs in-game all have the image on both the front and back, but if all you want is an image on the front, that's easy too. Go into Face Select mode and select just the back of your sign. Now, when you move the UV map, only the part corresponding with your selection will move. You can shrink it and place it on a different part of your image that doesn't show the front picture if you wish. For the purpose of this sign, though, let's just leave it where it was. The next requirement for the toolkit is to create 6 levels of detail, or LODs, or LODs, I've heard them called both. When you're up close to the model in-game, it will be at its most detailed, but as you get further away, that detail is not needed, so you make lower resolution versions of your object to display from a distance. First, you can shrink or remove that bottom view. If you want to remove it, just click and drag the diagonal lines in the corner down and it'll disappear. Go into Object Mode and select the sign. Look at the panel in the top right side of the screen. This is called the Outliner, showing all of the objects in your scene. Here, you can see that your object is called Plane. Double-click to rename it to sign_L0. This will be the first LOD, the most detailed one. make a copy by pressing Shift-D to duplicate it. You can move the copy around, but since we want it in exactly the same place, right-click and it will snap back to the location of the original. Double-click it in the outliner to rename it to sine_L1. Since you've now got two sines right on top of each other, you need a way to see them one at a time. There are a couple ways to do this. In the outliner, click the eyeball icon next to sine L0 and sine L1 to see how it toggles whether they're hidden or visible. You can use this to only see the objects you need to see. Another method is to place each LOD on a different layer. This is helpful because you can see the triangle count for each layer, and thus each LOD, separately. Layers are represented by these blocks at the bottom of the view. To move our sine L1 to a different layer, select it using the outliner so you don't accidentally choose the wrong one. Then go to Object, Move to Layer, or press M, and click the second box to move it to that layer. Now you can see that both layers have a dot on them showing that they contain at least one object each. Clicking on each block will show you only what's on that layer. View the layer you moved your sine L1 to. Select your sign and go into edit mode. From here, what you want to do is start getting rid of geometry. The toolkit guide recommends LOD1 is between 60 and 80% of the number of triangles of LOD0. LOD2 is 40 to 60%, LOD3 is 20 to 40%, LOD4 is 10 to 20%, and LOD5 is 0 to 10%. To find your goal for LOD1, multiply the number of triangles in your base model by 60%, which is 0.6, and by 80%, or 0.8. For example, my LOD0 is at 236 triangles, so my goal for this LOD is between 142 and 189. There are a few different ways to reduce the geometry of your sign, and I'll go over each of them as we go. An easy first step is to remove the insets you created to round off the edges of your sign, as that soft edge won't be visible from further away. In Edge Select mode, use the Alt key and right-click the inset edge to select it all. Press Delete and choose Dissolve Edges. Then, using Face Select mode, select the front of your sign and go to the Shading UVs tab in the left toolbar. Under Faces, choose the option Flat. Then repeat this on the bottom of your sign. That immediately drops our LOD1 down to 116 triangles, which is more than enough. It's not a problem if you're way over your goal. In fact, the faster you reduce the LOD triangle counts, the more efficient your sign will be in game. Return to object mode and make a copy of sine L1. Remember, Shift-D to duplicate. Use M to move this new object to the third layer, and make sure you click to go to the third layer at the bottom of the view. Rename this object to sine_L2. Make sure the new copy is selected and go into edit mode. LOD2 is between 40 and 60%, so multiply your base sine by 0.4 and 0.6. My goal for this LOD is between 94 and 142 triangles. I'm technically already there, but we're far enough away now that reducing more geometry won't hurt. A second way to reduce the geometry of our sign is to start getting rid of vertices along the edges. Most of the reductions we'll be doing for the next few LODs will be done like this. Using Edge Select mode, look for edges that are a good candidate for deletion. At first, look for ones that form only slight curves like this one. Select the edge, press Delete, and choose Dissolve Edges. You may also decide you want to change where a certain edge is to preserve your outline better. You don't want to just move an edge around as it can distort your UV mapped image. A better way is to use the Slide Edge tool and tell it to preserve the look of the UV map. For example, if I just removed this edge, I'd have one long section left here and one short one over here. Instead, I'd like the new edge to meet in between them. Select this edge and press G twice to activate Slide Edge. Now you can move it along either existing edge. Move it to a point in between it and the other edge and click to place. Now look at the bottom of the left menu and click the option that says Correct UVs. use these techniques to remove some of your object's edges. This may cause the front and back of your sign to be set back to smooth shading like the edges are, so use Face Select to choose both sides and, in the Shading UVs tab, set the faces to flat again. Now we're down to 80 triangles. Great! Go to Object Mode and do it again. Duplicate, move to a new layer, rename to Sign_L3, and return to Edit Mode to remove more geometry. I'll go ahead and speed up LOD 3 and 4 as it will be pretty much the same technique over and over. We're getting really far away from our object now, so a lot of detail can start to be removed at this point. Okay, we're down to our last LOD now. Go ahead and duplicate Sign_L4, rename it to Sign_L5, and move it to a new layer as usual. I wanted to show you one more technique, the Decimate Modifier. This is usually more useful for complex, organic shapes like animals, but you can sometimes use it at the lowest LODs of a simple object just to strip off a few more triangles. Make sure your fifth LOD is selected and go to the Modifiers tab with the icon that looks like a wrench. Click Add Modifier and choose Decimate. Adjusting the ratio will start automatically removing geometry from your model. Just remove enough that it's not pinching your model anywhere, and then click Apply to make the modifier permanent. And with that, our LODs are done. There are two more quick things to do before we export, and both will require us to select all of our sign's LODs at once. Hold down Shift while clicking each layer to show multiple layers at once. Then you can use the A key to select all of your sign's LODs. Remember, you may need to press it twice as it will deselect any selected objects first. In the outliner, you can double check to make sure all of your sign's LODs are selected if you can see that each LOD has an orange circle in front of it. As I mentioned in the setup video, for an object to face the correct direction in-game, its top, in this case the front of our sign, must face the Y-axis. The Y-axis is shown in green, and you can see which way is front by looking at the arrow on the widget here, or this indicator in the lower left side of the view. Make sure all LODs of your sign are selected, then use R and Z to rotate along the Z-axis only, and type 180 to spin your sign around 180 degrees. Next, use R and X to rotate along the X-axis, and type negative 90 to turn it to face the Y-axis. Finally, the last thing you should always remember to do is apply any rotating or scaling you may have done with your sign. Go to Object, Apply, and choose Rotation and Scale. That's it, we're ready to export. Go to File, Export, and choose FBX. Navigate to the folder you wish to save your exported file in, and for the settings, choose FBX 6.1 ASCII, Y Forward, which will automatically change the next setting to Z Up, and remove the checkbox from the Animation option. Then, choose Export FBX. Now, open your File Explorer and navigate to where you saved your FBX file. Add the three image files you downloaded for this tutorial to this folder as well, so it looks like this. I'll cover ways to create a good icon in another tutorial, but for now, I created an icon.png file for you to use. The other two graphics are the materials for your sign. Remember that all of the material graphic names must match the name you gave your material in Blender, and then they have a suffix designating what they're for. Popcorn_bc.png, for example, uses the suffix _bc, which makes it the base color. Popcorn_rn.png is a roughness map. Roughness is a grayscale image which determines how shiny parts of your object are in Planet Coaster. In this case, since we don't want our sign to be shiny at all, it's just a small, simple, all-white image. Select all of these files. Right-click, hover over Send To, and select Compressed Zipped Folder. Go to the Thememaker's Toolkit website, the link is in the description below. sign in using your Steam account. Once you're in, click Create New Item. Give it a name and description. Here I'm just imitating the naming conventions for similar items in-game. Basic popcorn sign for the name, and a simple popcorn sign for the description. For the file package, click and navigate to the zip file you just created, select it, and then choose Open. The preview image can be any picture that reminds you which object this is. You're the only one who'll ever see this. You can just use the popcornbc.png image here. Select the appropriate scenery category. In this case, I just choose shop signs under building, wall signs. Since the themes are pretty limited, I've just been choosing Planet Coaster if none of the others are appropriate. Leave the scenery type as simple. You'll only use the other option if you're making gridded building pieces. Similar signs are usually $5 in-game, and since it's not an animatronic, put the running cost at zero. The sound type just indicates the noise you want to hear when placing your object, and the sound size is how loud it is. A small plastic thump is appropriate for our sign. Ignore the flexi color choices for now, as we haven't set this sign up for flexi colors. Go ahead and click Submit. Your zip file will upload and go into the queue. After a short while, it will switch to say Building. Just a note, if you get an error instead, make sure you followed the steps in this tutorial exactly and try again. If you're really stuck, let me know the error in the comments below and I'll help, but try to troubleshoot it yourself first. Learning the errors and what causes them is valuable to know if you want to do more of this in the future. After a while, your object will say, Complete. And congratulations if this was the first object you created in the toolkit. Click the Download button. Go to Documents, or My Documents, depending on your version of Windows. Look for a folder called Frontier Developments. Under that, open Planet Coaster, and then TMT. Save the file in this folder. Now, open up Planet Coaster. Or, if you already have it open, go to the Toolkit Items tab and hit this button to refresh. Your item will appear in the list, and you can place it just like any other object in-game. When you've made an object you're happy with, you may want to upload it to the Steam Workshop. If you're following my popcorn sign tutorial, please don't upload your version of the popcorn sign, though. I've already done so, and it wouldn't make sense to have multiple versions popping up there, and I'd prefer you not use the graphics I created for workshop items. But if you make your own signs, or whatever else, upload away. To upload, place your object and then select it. Click the Upload to Steam button. Select New Workshop Item, and then you'll be prompted to take a screenshot of your object. Make sure to get a nice, well-lit screenshot, as this will be the first image people will see. When you're done, click Create Image. Finally, click Create Workshop Item to upload your finished object to the Steam Workshop. And that's it! You've now created a simple sign in the ThemeMaker's Toolkit. What else do you want to make now that you've come this far? What kind of toolkit tutorials would you like to see me do? Feel free to like or comment, and if you want random updates from my Planet Coaster exploits, subscribe. If you enjoy what I do and are interested in supporting the channel, check out my Patreon. In addition to helping me out, you can also get fun perks like voting on future projects or being the first to see new videos. That's all for now. Bye!